Yo, what's going on, Brady? Crypto Kid here, coming at you again with another video, guys. Today, we got an exciting one for you. I'm not going to lie. I'm really not sure why I haven't mentioned this strategy in the past, but to be honest with you, this is the only proven method that's worked for me and worked well to see those massive gains. So first off, if you haven't already, go ahead, hit that like button, hit that subscribe button. Coming up on 2,700, 3,000 subscribers is on the horizon. So go ahead, help me out. Hit that red subscribe button right now before you do anything else. And let's get right into the video. So first off, guys, let me just explain something to you real quick. If you don't already know what a market cap is, it's basically just the current price of the coin times the circulating supply. So a common mistake, especially people that are new to the space, is they're like, oh, okay, Bitcoin has a price of $11,400. XRP, for example, is only at 27 cents. XRP can go to Bitcoin's price someday. And yes, I mean, theoretically it could, but you have to look at the supply. So you can really only accurately compare the prices by looking at the market cap. So $210 billion versus $12 billion. So theoretically, XRP could go to Bitcoin's market cap someday. Probably not going to go to its price someday unless something absolutely crazy happened. So anyways, now that we got the market cap understood, I'm going to go ahead and tell you guys my favorite strategy. And you got to understand the market caps for this to work, but it's pretty easy to figure out. So we're going to come over to Coinbase because for me personally, this is the most popular exchange from where I'm from. Every single person I know that's into cryptocurrency uses Coinbase. I know Binance also, this would probably work for Binance too, because that's also a super popular exchange. But basically, what you got to think is Coinbase, a lot of people have it, a lot of people trust it. It's quite secure. It hasn't been hacked in quite a while from what I've heard. I haven't seen any sort of reports about people losing their money on Coinbase. Feel free to correct me in the comments if I got that wrong, but I personally haven't seen anything bad from Coinbase in quite some time. So anyways, we're going to come over to Coinbase, and we have to think, guys, let's be smart about this. This is how I called Orchid, if you guys were here, when I called Orchid at like 17 cents or whatever, and now it's trading at 40 cents. So this is how I called it. You come over to Coinbase, you go to the tradable assets, obviously, and then you come all the way down. So for this one, I like to stay under a $500 million market cap, because that's relatively low compared to some of these other coins that are in the billions. So you want to come over here under $500 million. And then from here, obviously we can't do DAI because DAI is a stable coin. But basically these coins right here are the ones that I'm going to be focusing on for my portfolio. Obviously, I think you'd be silly not to have a bag of Ethereum, XRP, Chainlink, Tezos, and maybe even XLM. And then obviously Bitcoin if you're more into safe trading. But once you have those bags figured out, guys, this is what you want to focus on, is these low market cap coins. Because what's going to happen is that as more people start to trickle into cryptocurrency, and we have to remember more people are discovering crypto every single day and learning to invest, there's just going to be more money pouring into these coins every single day, basically. And there's not a whole lot of sell pressure, especially because a lot of these coins operate on proof of stake rather than proof of work. So it's very easy for the price to go up over time. So what you're basically going to want to do, and this is what I'm doing, is these low coins, especially the ones Algorand, but they might be dumping soon, so I wouldn't recommend getting Algorand right now. So right now, basically, Kyber, Band, I'm going to wait for a pullback, hopefully, Augur, Numeraire, and then Orchid are the ones I'm focusing on right now. I also think Basic Attention Token is a super, super good coin. I made a video a while back on Basic Attention Token. I delved all into where I think the price is going. If you guys want to go ahead and check that out, it's a couple months old by now, but I still stand with all the information I said in that video. But yeah, these are basically the coins you want to focus on, guys, because you don't want to go ahead and find a coin like, I don't know, let's say Dash or something that already has an $805 million market cap, yet the technology isn't like, I mean, Dash has good technology, don't get me wrong, but there's a bunch of coins well ahead of it that are better than it, and there's not a whole lot of room for growth for Dash, especially given that it's not an extremely good currency compared to some of these other ones. So you want to find the low market cap ones that have room for growth. And ones like Orchid, which I mean, I think the market cap might be wrong. There's been some people speculating that this is just kind of like the wrong number. The circulating supply is actually bigger. But even if the circulating supply is bigger, Orchid still has a very small market cap, I think in like the $100 million range. So it's still very, very small. So Orchid, Numeraire, Augur, BAM Protocol, Kyber Network are all coins you're going to want to look into. Obviously, this is where it's up to you guys to do your own research and find which one of these you think has the best technology going for it and the best team around it. But once you found those coins that you support, their technology and everything, those are the ones that you want to go ahead and invest in. And then just hold on, guys, for 1 year, 2 years, 3 years. And at the end of the day, the fact that these coins are on Coinbase means that they're going to pump at some point, even if it's just a pump and dump. I know I don't love investing based off the concept that it's just going to eventually go up, but it's just the sad reality of crypto right now. It's not super advanced, and we're still very early in the markets, and at the end of the day, every single coin on Coinbase is going to pump again at some time in the future, and probably pump pretty damn hard. So just putting that out there, guys, you're going to want to go ahead and have a bag of some of these low market cap coins. Go ahead, look at the technology. I'll tell you right now, the ones I'm targeting, I obviously still have my Orchid bag. Numerera, I'm targeting heavily right now just because it's new to Coinbase, and I think that it hasn't really seen its price discovery phase. We obviously saw a big rise in Numerera earlier this year, maybe even this month, but then we've seen a pullback since then. I think it's going to basically do what Kyber did at the start of Kyber's addition to Coinbase, where it had a nice little jump at the start, but then eventually it just went absolutely parabolic. So anyways, Kyber, Augur, Numerera, and Orchid are my picks right now that I'm investing in. Hoping to hold on for a year, 2 years, 3 years, just seeing what happens. These are all coins that I personally believe are going to climb to $1 billion at least, and we're going to be seeing 300%, 400%, 500%, maybe even more if some of this technology picks up on these coins. So at the end of the day, guys, just to clarify what I've said, you want to target low market cap coins that are on very popular exchanges. Because they have access to more and more people, which means more money, especially ones like Coinbase. When people enter the space, they come into Coinbase and buy some of these coins. So go ahead, guys, get yourself a bag of low market cap coins with good fundamentals. Hold on a year or two, and I guarantee you'll thank me later. None of this is financial advice. Always do your own research. Let me know in the comments if you agree with this strategy. Personally, I don't really care if people disagree with this, because this is part of the way that I've made money in cryptocurrency, was just doing this strategy, and I made quite a bit of it. This has definitely been my most successful one, so maybe it hasn't worked for all of you, but me personally, speaking from experience, it has worked 100% for me. Once again, make sure to like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.